I'm Anthony Joshua. I'm going to watch some boxing movies and tell you what I think about them.
Don't take no abuse! This is your time, Mickey!
So here we have the fighter as well. Do you know what I like about this? It looks like it's actually real. I'm actually shocked. Wow. And this is what an actual boxing fight's like. That's why you can see a lot of parents with like their kids doing it, because it's brutal.
What do you think of Mark Wahlberg's shot?
Phenomenal. Phenomenal. He's done a great job here, because that's what I was wondering. The combinations that he's throwing look like he's done it many times before. And the passion he's shown there when he gets the victory. It's great acting skills. It just makes you feel like you're actually at a fight. So here we have Rocky IV. We have Ivan Drago against Rocky Balboa. It's a serious fight here. You've got the scientific athlete against the old rugged and rough athlete. Rocky's having a tough time, but he's sticking in there. This film here is a classic though. You can't beat a bit of Rocky. If it comes on TV and everyone sees Rocky's on and they've got to be in bed in an hour, they might stay up to watch the Rocky film, because even though they've watched it a few times, it's just a classic that you don't mind watching again. And it's probably something that you've missed. This film here, or the whole series of films, is classical in my opinion. So here we are watching Creed. Creed is good, it's a legacy, it's a continuation from Rocky. Mm-hmm.
Why'd you make it happen? Can you do it?
Let's do it.
All right. Let's make it happen.
What I like about this film is that they actually included real fighters in it.
You gon' get it, chump. You're the future of this division. You wear that name of pride.
So it makes it more than just a film. I think Michael B. Jordan was a perfect person for the film as well. He's passionate about what he's doing and he's definitely put the work in. The fighting scenes were a continuation, it wasn't chopped up. And practice, it was just a continuation. That's great acting skills. It just keeps you fully engaged. So I think it's really good that it's in one take, to be fair with you.
What's the best Rocky movie?
All of them. Without number one, there'll be no number five, number four. So they all make up for the complete package. The thing with the Rocky film, that's what makes it what it is. You know, it's the passion, it's the over the top, it's the drive of an athlete, it's him chasing pigeons, him punching meat in the freezer, running up the Philadelphia steps. Oh, yeah! They've used the Rocky film in so many different aspects, like the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. It caught onto a lot of people's imaginations, and that's what films are supposed to do. That's why sometimes being over dramatic captures the minds of the people, so they've done a good job. Here we have The Simpsons. Me versus Andy Ruiz.
Okay, Homer, nothing to be worried about. Just
the second one, by the way. So he's just punching Homer, jabbing his head off at the minute, and it's only 6 seconds in.
Jeez, only 6 seconds in. Attaboy, Homer. Keep dancing.
Everyone loves a bit of boxing. It's made its way through so many different aspects of comedy, of film. And Mike Tyson was my favorite fighter as well. He's a true icon of the sport. For me, I would say my favorite film of those, of the fighting scenes, was The Fighter.
Ford lands a huge left hook as Mickey.
The thing with The Fighter is that I was actually watching and I thought, wow, those combinations actually look like someone's actually boxing. And I went on later to find out that he had practiced every punch that Mickey Ward threw in his fight. So it made more sense to me. And from that aspect, I would say The Fighter is the best film.